just a workhorse for him. And again, you talk about being some team's best player. Sorokin has been more often than not for the Islanders.
We are underway from downtown St. Paul. Minnesota trying to snap a losing streak on home ice. They've dropped their last six. Here comes Kaprizov in. Kaprizov for a shot. And a shoulder save by Sorokin that deflects up and out of play.
They've got no points to give up and surrender, so they've just been riding their number one goaltender.
Fleury poke checks this away. Barzal drops it back to Lee for a shot. And a save by Fleury. Skips by Boldy, but Kaprizov works off the boards. Poke checked off of his stick. Recovered by Zuccarello. Across to Boldy, a shot. Save Sorokin. Rebound goes to the corner. Pellet can't get it by Faber at the line. Boldy for Eriksson Ek in the slot. A shot off the post. Rebound controlled by Boldy on the wall.
He gets this one in the slot, very similar to where Anders Lee was. Right off the outside.
Zuccarello down low. Kaprizov takes a whack behind the net from Dobson. Boldy out to Faber. Faber, Zuccarello, a shot, scores!
Yeah, I was curious how Brock Faber would run this power play. He got everybody back. He's going to have the confidence. A nice little play there, and it's the movement at the top of the point that draws the Islanders' defense out to the middle of the ice, get their skates going the wrong direction, feeds Matt Zuccarello, and he doesn't bother going north. I think sometimes teams can be guilty of just kind of resting on their laurels a little bit when some of their star players come back, but that's where the start to this game has been encouraging.
Down low, Barzal, his shot. Deflects to the wall. Horvat over to hold for New York. Comes free to Dobson. Back to Barzal. A shot saved by Fleury.
Great sequence there from the Wild's top unit.
Aho with a shot saved by Fleury. And Foligno carries to center ice. Foligno fires. And a save made by Sorokin. He then covers.
Yeah, absolutely. And the Islanders with a bunch on there. I mean, Kyle Okposo, too, he probably has five of his 600 points in an Islander sweater.
Mike Riley's joined this club recently. Technically not a Minnesota native, but grew up in Minnesota. This one's off the post from Horvat. Couldn't get one by Fleury.
Yeah, the Islanders, this is their second chance from the slot. Anders Lee the first, and Horvat with some space there off a nice little feed, quick wrister.
Barzal with it. Across for Nelson. Nelson and Dobson play catch. Dobson a shot, save, rebound, the clearing attempt, hit Gaudreau. Islanders able to maintain the zone.
Well, those failed clears usually come back to burn you. They have a chance, time to clear it, don't get it down.
Dobson, Nelson a drive, pad save, Fleury. Second. Riley plays across to the near side for Engvall, back to Riley. Engvall a drive, pad save, Fleury. Rossi moving in. Thought about a shot, instead goes back to Hunt. Across Johansson, back to Hunt. Now Rossi. Rossi fires, had a save by Sorokin. Rossi got it back. 15 in the power play. Hartman shot, sails over the top of the goal. Dobson's become the rock on the blue line for the Islanders. One of the top scoring defensemen in the league. Number three in that department. Also a plus 17 overall player. Deflected shot. The Islanders will be offside, so they had to allow Minnesota easy exit. Foligno recovers the puck, flings it on goal, and a save by Sorokin. Brodin to Johansson. Johansson tries to walk to the slot, got it to Bogosian. Wines fires, and a save by Sorokin.
I think Scott Stevens, Scott Niedermeyer. So that's certainly been a core piece of the Islanders. And again, but today's game, you need offense. The Islanders are chasing it now, and the give-take is something on the defensive end. All around impressive what he's been able to accomplish in his career.
Underway in the second. Islanders win the draw. There was a lot to like about the Wild's first period. Score aside, just the pace, the intensity was different. Here's a takeaway and a chance for Dury. Scores! Connor Dewar heading at a point in 17. Lights the lamp for Minnesota. It's 2-0 Wild.
The Islanders and Aho into an indirect passing play that is just never going to connect. And Dewar ready, good spot, on his toes, jumps that poor pass, finds some room in the middle of the ice. Aho can't recover in time. Low blocker, Doer hits his mark. Sorokin can't catch up to it.
Gives to Johansson. Back to Hartman. Johansson with a tip. Saves Sorokin. Rebound loose. Middleton had a chance. And Sorokin hangs on.
A tough breakout. Turnover. Nice little middle lane drive. A kick out there. And then it's the defender up in the rush. That's Middleton. He makes the breakout pass, but he doesn't rest on his laurels. He gets up there, collects this rebound. Second chance.
And those numbers go back to the day that Gustafson came out. Here's Maroon on the backhand. A save by Sorokin. Puck is still loose. Sorokin trying to pin it up against the near side pipe.
The first period, where he just uses that flexibility. He's almost full splits there. And it's up underneath his steel, pinched against the post. It's loose in there. A lot of sticks, but yeah, just stuck right under the steel. Palmieri had to help out there. All hands on deck for the Islanders.
Give and go with Zuccarello. Back to Kaprizov again. Centered for Eriksson Ek. He wanted a tip. It goes just wide. Boldy in behind for Zuccarello. To Kaprizov. Centers. Eriksson Ek scores!
First, you don't succeed. Try and try again, and Kaprizov tried for Eriksson Ek early in this shift. I mean, they're making the right reads, the right plays, they're passing at the right time.
Here's a turnover, however, and it leads to a chance for Clutterbuck that goes off the crossbar. Fleury says thank you very much.
In his role, that's a boatload. And I think Fleury, I think he gets a piece of this right before it catches the crossbar.
He got it through to Kaprizov. He fires, saved by Sorokin. Rebound chance, and it's just wide. Faber has it, and at the horn, he sends it wide.
22 shots on goal, and not easy ones either. Kaprizov in the dying seconds, walking down Broadway. And there's just chaos. Now, I don't think that this means that Lane Lambert's throwing the towel in on the Islanders' night. But he needs some kind of spark. They haven't had anything going offensively.
Johansson fakes the shot. Still has it in the corner. Rossi spins away from Fasching. Got it back to Hunt. Hunt a shot off the post. Rebound picked up by Rossi. Stripped away by Romanov at this inexperienced goaltender.
Boy.
Riley plays it in. Pajot works out from behind the net, a shot saved by Fleury, rebound Holmstrom.
Pajot, as he sets up in Gretzky's office, comes out, makes the play, and two Islanders on the backside get something on that.
Foligno trying to force it out of the zone. Dobson at center, pull checked away, it's a two-on-one shorthanded. Eriksson Ek moves in, a shot, he scores! Second of the night for Eriksson Ek, and the shorthanded goal makes it 4-0 Minnesota.
Look at all three of the Wild Killers in that little quadrant. The good six kept it in that spot, and then gets out to the neutral zone. Another good stick from Marcus Foligno, dislodges this puck, gets it to Eriksson Ek. They're off to the races, 2-on-1, and you give Eriksson Ek this shot. I think you got to give credit to the coaching staff, too. There hasn't been panic. You know, they challenged the guys. The guys responded themselves. It's been complete.
1 minute remaining in the third period. 1 minute.
And the Wilds score again to make it 5. Toward the finish line. What a pass across from Gaudreau to Foligno.
Well, just a pretty passing play altogether. It's Brodin with the keep at the blue line, taking the middle ice. Gaudreau with a nice one-touch to Foligno.
Patrick Roy, as we've talked about so many times, his hero as a youngster. Pellick fires wide. Final seconds. And there it is. A shutout for Fleury for 5:52.